Right here I'm talking to a new Lego France designer. So good to see you, and what is your name?
I'm David, and I'm from France, and I am working at Lego since 2 years now.
This sounds great, yeah. And you're part of a Lego France team. Exactly. Have you started in this team?
No, I started on DC Superhero Girls, and then I moved to France. Yeah, so it's very, very joyful to work in here, yeah.
So we can talk a lot about Lego France, yeah. Because I have two daughters at home.
Okay.
So Lego France is out there in our room. First of all, have you been involved in designing those sets here?
So the sets I'm designing right now, they are going to be out next year. But for this one, for example, I co-designed it. So I didn't finish the model, but I helped during the development. So that's why this one is very, this one is one of my favorite, yeah.
And very special. So we can talk about it because I'm a big kart fan. So I don't drive karts on my own, but I used to play Mario Kart all the time.
Yeah, exactly.
And I buy all the Polybag stuff. Whenever there's a kart, it's fun. And now we have, I think, 4 Lego France kart sets, and you can combine them all.
Yes.
What is the idea behind this new theme?
So first of all, it was to add more action to the France universe. So racing was testing very well for the girls, especially in Germany, actually. So we decided to go for this as a purse team. And especially when you're combining it, it's with more function now. You can basically throw your cart over there. So it's not...
Once more, please.
Okay, so basically, first you need a driver, let's say. For today, Emma is driving, okay? And then... you're putting her like this, and then you have a launcher here, and poof, and then you can race with your friends. So it's not more about, it's not so much about house play inside, but this one is more action based. So that's why we went for this one, to maybe make the France universe evolve a bit. So yeah.
Yeah, we've seen many areas in the Hard Lake City. We had snow last summer. Now we have those carts. What you can do, you can actually have kind of a racetrack here.
Uh-huh.
What I was thinking when I see all those sets in the Toy Fair in Nuremberg, that there is only one thing missing, a track. Yeah. So you have to use your bricks at home.
Exactly, so if you have a bunch of bricks at home, you can use a track, or you can also use some props from your house and basically play like in Micro Machines. So you can put some cups and everything, and you can race, and it also works, but it's also nice with bricks. So if you can build a big track, it could be amazing, yeah?
But you know, I know those 5 girls here. This is Emma, right?
Yeah.
But she doesn't wear a helmet, so it's a little bit risky here.
No, she's coming actually from this set because she's supposed to have a cozy time on her studio.
There we see the helmet. Yeah, okay,
yeah,
I'm fine.
Yeah, no. We have a new. Actually, we have a very new helmet element which has a ponytail behind, so it's more appealing for girls. So exactly.
So I wouldn't say anything.
Yeah.
And she didn't stand there. It's so fun. So you've been involved in this set designing. What is your part here when we look at the set?
It was basically, so one of my friends was designing it, and because we are sparing with designers, we are not the only one doing one thing. So basically, because we are working all around a table, sometimes you can get some hints and tricks. Oh, how can you do that? I'm a bit stuck or something. So I used to help my friend, but she did it. It's not my own set, okay? I don't want to be in trouble with her.
But I like that you're using the azure blue here and the dark blue.
Yeah.
So it looks, I mean, as an adult fan of Lego, we always discuss about Lego France and think, oh, this is a nice set. Maybe we could change the colors a little bit right here. I think, okay, I would change this one, the mirror, but anything else is very, very fine. This could be also part of the Lego City.
Cool, but I'm glad you like it because it was a challenge to find some new colors, still being part of the Friends universe, but something that is a bit more action-based, as I said. So maybe changing, tweaking the colors a bit. And because this one is from Olivia, and she's the tech girl, so that's why she has the truck and she can fix everything. She has a robot also, so that could be also mega appealing. So yeah.
So we've seen the new carts here. We've seen the amusement park like 2 years ago. There's a lot of fun going on in Hard Lake City. And there's something, of course, was a lot of discussion about the change of the faces of the Lego France. So I mean, when I ask you your personal opinion, do you think it was time to change something?
For me, it's super fine because we were like before to take a decision, we are testing things, and we were finding out that some girls they were also identifying themselves not because of the hobby or because of oh I like playing music or I like playing guitar or anything or tennis for example, but also because of the origin, where do you come from, and this is super important for girls. So I feel like it was a fair point to try to put some more background, like family background, where do you come from. Yeah, that was fair enough. Yeah,
it's totally fine. So again, we see a lot of figures here. So beside the new card sets, there are going to be new releases in summer, and you have to help me out right here. What is otherwise new? I know. There is the new kind of a hotel with a track around, yeah. For example.
That's the new summer, yeah, with the lake, and then you have the track that goes around, and it's super cool and super action-based also, because you can throw the cart, it goes all around and come back. So it's like a summer hub, kind of high-class hotel, so it looks super cool, yeah.
Perfect for us, but I just built the awesome Lego Creator Expert roller coaster. Uh-huh. So the big with the red track. So what was it like when Lego was producing those new elements? Was the CEO who was running around to every team, you need to use those new tracks? So because we were seeing them at Unikitty, for example, in your Lego friends, it's great to see them all over because I love them, but it's kind of every theme there is the new roller coaster track.
It's because it's very inspiring for us, because this element is here since a long time now. So to be honest, that was in development when I came 2 years ago, and we thought, okay, this is super fun, it works super well, why don't you use it for every SKU? And you can do it because it's very very active, you know, it's not passive, you can play a lot with it. So yeah,
I think it works really fine, very smooth, so it's good to see that it's in Lego France too. And the funny thing is, we've seen the roller coaster there, so the old one, so maybe you're looking forward, I mean, we cannot talk about future products, but it would be great to see a real roller coaster in the future in the Hartwig City too, right?
Stay tuned, because, yeah.
Stay tuned!
Exactly! Yeah.
We're looking forward to maybe a Hartwig City roller coaster then. So, what is... When you say you're part of the Lego France design team, what is special to work with a team to have those mini dolls, which is a little bit different from than the other themes?
But for me, it's super fine. Actually, I came to Lego because of the mini doll, because I really liked it. And I was building home and I was building with mini dolls, and I was putting them on some other settings. And then I got this position here and I was like, I'm so happy. Because for me, it's more appealing, like the body is more appealing. So I think it's super fine and it works, like it fits the system. So why don't you use the mini doll if you like the appeal of it, yeah?
I always talk with kind of all of your colleagues, because there's one thing my daughter doesn't like about the mini dolls. Okay. So she didn't really care that they look different, a little bit, I have to say, a little bit my girlfriend also, because of the new glasses and the things, but it's I think they are fine right now. But what my daughter always is missing, that there are no studs on the back, so that you have always to use flat tiles that the figure can stick here. Do you think this is a compromise which is good, or do you think maybe studs would be cool, it would be easier to design things?
So this is a compromise that we had to make to actually have a very thin body that appeals more to girls and maybe boys also. So that's why you don't have any connection here, because of this connection on the bottom. But we are thinking about improving this connection. So maybe stay tuned, and then but you can also use the foot plate and it works quite fine. Yeah, it's basically to have a nice body, because the girls, they are super picky with this kind of things. So depending of if you're looking this from behind, there is studs, it's not appealing so much. So that's why we took this decision, yeah.
It's a different play, and it's totally fine that we have another thing here as well. So when we look at this set here, this is new also, right? Am I right?
You know? It's the diner / open cinema. So on this one, for example, you can put your phone here. It's a very simple phone stand. So if you're removing,
I have a phone right here. So
put it there. You can put it here, and then let's say, okay, I'm done with karting. I can just chill out and relax and watch an episode of whatever.
Of a new zusammengebaut video.
of the new Lego Friends content, for example. Yeah.
This is better.
So, hopla, oh, sorry. Oops. Like this. Yeah.
Great. So we have a little cinema here for cars. And next to this, we have the diner. Have you talked to Mike before that? Because he was designing a diner also for Create Expert. And have you been in contact?
Not directly. I mean, we know what everybody is doing pretty much. But it's not like we are copying something. Or it's just because it could be appealing for creator, but it could also be mega appealing for girls, especially this kind of burger, big shapes and everything. It's round. It's cozy. You have the cinema outside. It's mega appealing for girls. Yeah.
We can maybe have a look inside.
Yeah,
so would you, or would you like to add put?
Okay. It's just like
some bricks are.
Something is stuck over there. So let's
I just give you 10 seconds and go.
Voilà.
Ah, here we go.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
we have the diner.
Exactly.
This is a printed piece here.
Yeah, you have a round tile with the egg decoration on it. So if you want to cook some pancakes or whatever, you have some eggs, ketchup, mayo, salt and pepper, obviously. And you can take a ride also on the fake moving, I don't know, do you call this like machine? Yeah.
This looks really great, Matthias.
Yeah.
Please, close up here. This looks stunning. And this is always the discussion. When I buy a new Lego Friends set for my daughter, I ask her if I maybe could use the printed tiles, and she said no. So this is really great.
Cool.
Because this is great. I love it.
Cool, but I'm glad you like it. I'm glad your doctor will play with it because yeah, we are trying to add a lot of tiny details like this. So you have a lot of foot play on this one, and also some I don't know what you call this, like when you need to handle the money and everything. So yeah. This one is pretty much a classic Friends set with the house play inside, but still with something outside to do. Yeah.
So those are the parts of the set here, right? The cinema and the diner. So before that, we can talk a little bit about your history at Lego. You worked for Superhero Girls. I think this was very interesting, but wasn't the big success, I guess. There are going to be any new sets, am I right?
For now, I don't know. I have no idea, but I got moved to France. So, but it was very, very interesting to work in it because it was, for example, so this one is not one of my sets, but it was also with mini dolls, but with a lot of action. So yeah, I hope it will still go somewhere because it's really, really cool. Yeah.
It's fun to see, and we have kind of little buggy here too, so it could be part of the Hada Sigi where the racing is going on.
Exactly. And yeah, you can mix up, yeah.
Yeah, so this is very interesting. Of course, you cannot tell us what are you doing right now. Maybe you're building a big Hard Lake City roller coaster.
Uh-huh.
But I would like to talk a bit about your history. May I guess you're from French?
Yes, I am. I am so sorry for my English.
No, it's totally fine. It's better than mine.
Okay, no, I'm from France, yeah. I was in the video game industry before, and I got hired 2 years ago, so yeah.
So what have you done in the video industry? What was your part?
I studied computer design, computer graphics, and I worked on some companies in France. And then I also never stopped building with Lego. And that was the thing in my life. I liked the video game and I liked Lego. And at some point I wanted to change to just maybe get out a bit of the screen and do something more manual. And I tried to apply here and it worked. So I'm super happy.
This sounds great.
Yeah.
And of course, when you say you have a graphic designer background, you can tell the Lego graphic designers what to do.
Yeah. But we are working in close collaboration with them. It means like if we have some ideas, for example, for this decoration here, or if we have an idea for a decoration, we are saying, okay, we are building a dinner right now. It could be nice to have a screen. If you're removing your phone, it could be nice to still have something to see. So we are talking with them what could be inside the screen and everything. So it's, and then they are coming back. They are printing some prototypes, sticker prototypes, and we are trying, maybe this color is not working so much. Maybe this could be this color, or this is super nice. We are keeping it. And that's like the very close collaboration. It's a very, very nice team, this Friends team, yeah.
And I maybe have mentioned in every interview I did with the designer in the last 30 years that I don't like stickers. And the fun thing about Lego Friends is I have the feeling that many girls like stickers, but my daughter is always shouting, Papa, you have to come, you have to put the stickers.
Okay,
so thank you very much.
You're welcome. So it's you putting the stickers. But we discovered that compared to boys, some girls, they are more, it's easy for them to handle it because they are very, I don't know what you call this in English, meticulous. So yeah, so I think in this case, And most of the girls are happy with the stickers we are making. Yeah.
Is there anything missing, in your opinion, in the Heart Lake City? So, if you have a dream, I mean, of course, we're going to talk about the future. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But if you could choose one and could tell Lego, I would like to see this in Heart Lake City, what would it be?
For me, it would be more vehicles. It's happening now, but more like classic vehicles maybe. But it's like a personal taste because I'm a vehicle guy more than a building guy. So yeah, if there is trucks or... Because I don't know, trucks are also appealing for girls. Why not to have more trucks? Yeah, could be cool.
This is a great dream. So I think we're going to eat popcorn right now. Thank you so much for your time. It was fun talking about this new lineup. I'm looking forward to the card sets. Uh-huh. I will buy them for my daughter, of course. And the burger is very fine. And yeah, we're going to see what is happening next. And all the best for you.
Thanks a lot. And thanks for having me. Yeah, it was very nice to get interviewed by you. Yeah.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Bye.
Bye-bye.